children. So the next topic will be reading a CSV file into a dictionary. Take page number 252 in your textbook. Topic 13.6.6, reading CSV file into a dictionary. So to read a CSV file into a dictionary can be done by using dict reader, that is the dictionary's first four letters, DICT, reader class of CSV module. Module means it's nothing but the small programs which work similar to the reader class, but creates an only the difference between the dictionary reader and the reader classes, creates an object which maps data to a dictionary. So what do you mean by map? Mapping means it's a process of creating a data element between the two data models. So the only difference between the dictionary reader and reader class is it creates an object which maps the data to a dictionary. That is, it create or assign the data to the data model. That's data to the dictionary. Dictionary is the data model. So it creates the object which maps data to a data model, that is dictionary. So the keys are given by the field names as parameter. So the dictionary key, how it can be given means the keys are given by the field names as the parameter. So each and every column is called a field. So that field name is a parameter. So dictionary reader works by reading the first line of the CSV and using each comma separated value in this line as a dictionary key. So the dictionary reader, how it works? It works by reading the first line of the CSV file, and it will take the comma separated value, each and every comma separated value as a dictionary key. In case in your field name as a item name and quantity, comma price, that like the field name, that is the field name. So the item name is one field name, then quantity is one field name, then price is one field name. So these three can be taken it as a dictionary key. So in the columns in each subsequent row then behave like a dictionary values. So the columns can be behave like a value. So below the item name you have a keyboard, means that keyboard is the dictionary value. So that item name is a dictionary key, then keyboard is the dictionary value. Like that quantity is the field name, that quantity is a dictionary key. Then 48, in case the keyboard number of keyboards is 48, keyboards are 48, means that 48 is called a dictionary value. So the columns in each subsequent rows then behave like a dictionary value and can be accessed with the appropriate key. That what is that key? That is the field name. Okay, the next one, so the main difference between the CSV reader and dictionary reader is simple terms. CSV.reader and CSV.writer, these three are used in the CSV reader module. So that CSV.reader and CSV.writer works with the list and tuple. Underline that line. The reader will be work with the list and tuple, but the CSV.reader will works with the dictionary. So the main difference between the CSV reader and dictionary reader is in simple terms. That means the CSV.reader we had already learnt about it, then CSV.writer also we had already learnt. These two works with only list and tuple, while CSV.dictReader and CSV.dictWriter work with the dictionary. Underline that line, because that's why it is called a dictionary reader and dictionary writer. Here you see the example. In the above program, page number 252, last paragraph, here in the program, you have a CSV.dictionaryReader open file name. Then it is in the read mode. That R is used to represent the mode of the file, that is in the read mode. So in the above program, dictionary reader is used to read sample a.csv file and map into the dictionary. So then the function here you see, the function dictionary is used to print the data in the dictionary format without order. So here the csv.dict.reader is used to read the file. Then the last line in the program, last line you have a print statement. That statement you have print, then dictionary row. It is used to print the data in the dictionary format without any order. In case, here you see the note, page number 253, the first paragraph. Here, if you remove the dictionary function from the above program and use only print row, your output will be comes along with the ordered dictionary. So if you use dictionary function means without order you have the output. If you remove the dictionary function means your output will be in the orderly manner. So that is called ordered dictionary. You see the output. Then the next one is reading CSV file with the user defined delimiter into a dictionary. User defined delimiters. Delimiters means some special characters. So you can also register new dialects and use it in the dictionary reader method. Suppose sample 8.csv. So you can also register a new dialects and use it in the dictionary reader method. Suppose sample 8.csv is in the following format. So here you see, what do you mean by dialect? Dialect means what? Dialect means it is a format of CSV file which we need to read. So dialect is nothing but the some format. We have to format that file which we want to read. Here you see the items and quantity will be separated by the pipeline, that is the skip initial space. So you have to, for that you have to use csv.register dialect method. So dictionary reader, here you see the node. Dictionary reader gives ordered dictionary by default in its output. An ordered dictionary is a dictionary subclass. So ordered dictionary is nothing but the subclass of dictionary. So which saves the order in which the contents are added. To remove the ordered dictionary, use dictionary. That only explained in the first paragraph. So if you want to, your output will display in the orderly manner means you remove the dictionary function, DICT function. In case if you want to display your output in the orderly manner means you have to use the removing your dictionary function and you have the ordered dictionary manner. Okay, so the order, actually dictionary reader function, you see the note page number 253, that note, dictionary reader function gives ordered dictionary by default in its output. In the order dictionary is a dictionary subclass which saves the order in which its contents are added. So to remove the order dict, you have to use the dictionary function. The next one is writing data into different types of CSV files. So as you know, Python provides an easy way to work with the CSV file and has CSV module to read and write the data in CSV file. In the previous topic, you have learned how to read CSV files in Python. In similar way, you can also write a new or edit an existing CSV files in Python. So the last topic, we had seen how to read the CSV files in Python. Here we have to see how to write a new file, otherwise how to modify, how to update the file, how to insert the delimiters in the file. So we have 8 types. One is, first one is a creating a new normal CSV file. Second one is modifying an existing file. Then writing on a CSV file with quotes. Then writing on a CSV file with custom delimiters. Custom delimiters means our user defined delimiters. Then writing on CSV file with the line terminator. Line terminator. Then writing a CSV file with the quote characters. Then write a CSV file into a dictionary. Then getting data at runtime and writing in a file. Getting data at runtime. During runtime, you can get your data and writing in a file. So the first one here we are going to see one by one. First one is creating a new normal CSV file. How to creating a new normal CSV file. So the csv.writer method. So the method is the csv.writer method returns a writer object which converts the user's data into a delimited strings on the given file like object. So what is the purpose of this writer method? It is converts the user's data into a delimited strings on the given file like object. So it will convert your data in the file like object. So when you have a set of data, that page number 254, when you have set of data that you would like to store inside the CSV file, it's time to do the write function. So read function, then the opposite function is the write function. So the csv.writer method returns a writer object which converts the user's data into a delimited strings on the given file like object. So the right row method, writer method, then the right row method writes a row of data into a specified file. So here you have to see two methods. One is csv.writer, another one is a write row method. So what is the purpose of csv.writer method? It is used to convert the data into a delimited string and in the form of file like object. Convert the data into the form of file like object. Then the write row method used to writes the row of data in a specified file. Then what is the syntax for csv.writer? Here you have like csv.reader, you have csv.writer, file object, delimiter, then format parameters. In csv, here you see csv.reader object also have a this one last topic we had seen, file object, delimiter and format parameters. Like that csv.writer also have a file object, delimiter and format parameters. Here what is the purpose of file object? File object passes the path and the mode of the file. So you have to give the path to open the file, no? That path and the mode of the file means reading mode, writing mode, binary mode, some more than 2-3 modes we had seen in the last topic. So it will specify the path of the file and the mode of the file. Then second one is a delimiter. Delimiter is a optional parameter. It is not necessary, it is not compulsory. So it's optional one. So it's containing the standard dialects like that comma, pipeline, etc. can be omitted. Then formatting parameters, this is also optional one. This is also not compulsory. So optional parameter which helps to override the default values of the dialects like skip initial space and quoting, that can be also omitted. So you can create a normal CSV file using writer method in the CSV module having a default. So the default delimiter is comma. In reader function also the default delimiter is comma. So here in writer method also you have the default delimiter, it's a comma. So here is an example. You see the example. The following Python program converts a list of data into CSV file called people.csv that uses comma as a value separator. So here the CSV data is student age. So student and age is called the field name. Here you see the student and age is called the field name. That is also called the dictionary key. So the field name is acting as a parameters. Then it is a dictionary key. So student are Dhanush, Kalyani and Ram. Then the age are 17, 18 and 15. So here the student and age is called a dictionary key. Then corresponding their values, Dhanush, Kalyani and Ram are called the dictionary value. And the 17, 18 and 15 is also called the dictionary value. So in this program, we are convert the data into a string file and create a string file. Then we have to write all the data into the file. So the first one, we have to convert your data into a string file object. The second one, you have to write all the data in the file name people.csv. So for that, in this program, page number 255, the first program, in this program, the program line, fourth line and fifth line, we are using two functions, two methods. The first method is csv.writer. So what is the purpose of csv.writer? So csv.writer converts all the data into a strings and it creates the file. So it will convert the data and make the file ready to write into the new file. Then the second function, writer rows, csv data. So the writer rows function, that function or method you can call any one name. So that writer rows will write all the data into the people.csv file. So we are using two methods. One is writer method, another one is writer rows method. Okay. So here in note you see the writer row method writes one row at a time. If you need to write all the data, you have to use the write rows. So in presentation also you can see the writer rows method writes all the data. All the data into the new CSV file. So that S is the difference. The write row method writes one row at a time. So if you need to write all the data at once, you can use the write rows method. Here use the example and the output you can see. The next one is modifying an existing file. So how do you modify an already created file? So making some changes in the data of the existing file. or adding more data is called a modification. That definition we had already know. So here you see the program. So here the list stores the row of the file. So the line list reader know that list is save the row. So you see the program in page number 256. Here lines equal to list reader. The list is stored in each row of the data in the list. Then the next line is lines 3 equal to row. Lines 3 equal to row. So here in the above program, the third row of the student.csv is modified and saved. So your output will be here. You see page number 255. So the datas are Harshini, Adit, Duru, Krishna, and Vengat. From this one is already created file. From this, the third line you have to change, and the third line to be replaced with Meena and Bangalore. So here you have the line 3 is used to change. So in the above program, the third row of student.csv is modified and saved. First, the student.csv file is read by using the csv.reader function. So here you have to use the csv.reader function to read the file. Then the list stores each row of the file. So the list reader, you know, that list is stores the each row of the file. Then the statement line 3 equal to row. So line 3 equal to row, change the third row of the file and the new content in the row. So the file object writer using writer rows writes the values of the list to student.csv. So here the csv.reader function used to read the file. Then lines equal to list reader used to stores each row of the file. Then the lines 3 equal to row in the program, the lines within the square bracket 3 equal to row used to change the third value and replaced with the new one. Then the writer row will be write the new value into your student.csv file. So this is the process of updating or modifying an existing file. Then next one is adding new row. How to add a new row? Already created file, and that file you are not going to replace any rows, but you can add a new row. So sometimes you may need to add a new rows in the existing CSV file. Adding a new row at the end of the file is called appending a row. So adding a new row at the end of the file is called appending a row. To append the row, you have to use the letter A. That one already we had seen in the last topic. So the following program add a new row. Here you see import CSV. So the new row will be 6, Sajini and Madurai. So the row number is 6, Sajini is the name, then Madurai is the city. So here you have to add the new row with the write row option. So writer csv.writer. What is the purpose of writer method? It is used to convert the data into the string, given data into the string. Then next one, writer row option used to add the writer. Here you see with open student.csv, then what is the mode? In the program, page number 257, the first program, the third line you have with open student.csv, comma A. So that A used to represent its append mode. So you have to append, that is joining the new row at the end of the file. So you have to specify it as a append mode. Then that csv.writer method used to convert the data into the strings. Then the csv, the writer.writeRow will write the single row of the data in your file. So your output will be, you have 6 records. The 6th one is 6, Sajini, Madurai. Okay. Then you see the, do you know, the W write mode creates a new file. If the file is already existing, W mode overwrites it. Okay. Whereas A append mode add the data at the end of the file. If the file already exists, otherwise creates a new one. So write row takes one dimensional data, that is one row that we had already seen. The write rows takes two dimensional data, that is multiple rows and write in a file. Okay. Then the CSV files, you see here, you see the difference. So the write row and the write rows. So it takes one dimensional data, write row. Then write rows takes two dimensional data, multiple rows to in a file. Then next one is CSV files with quotes. So you can give the quotes with double quotes, triple quotes into your CSV file. This one already the same process of csv.reader functions. Okay, so you can write the CSV files with quotes by registering new dialects. Dialects means the format which we are given to the file need to read it. So the new dialects using CSV register underscore dialect method. So that is a method, that otherwise module method or module. So that module is a CSV dot register underscore dialect method is used to give the quotes in your file. So in the above program, you see page number 258. In the program, the information is serial number, person, and date of birth. So you had given 5 datas. Then the CSV, you have to use the CSV dot register underscore dialect method. Here the quoting equal to inside the dialect method, my dialect, the quoting equal to CSV dot quote all. So you have to give the quotes to all the datas. Then your output will be like this. Here you see serial number also double quotes, person also double quotes, date of birth also double quotes. So quote all, which is used to give the quotes to all your datas. So in the above program, the dialect name my dialect is registered, declared. Quoting equal to CSV dot quote all allows to write the double quotes on all the values. Then next one is CSV files with the custom delimiters. Custom delimiters means our user defined delimiters. So here you see a delimiter is a string used to separate fields. So it is a string used to separate the fields. The default value is comma, underline that line, page number 258. Underline that line. The default value delimiter is comma. You can have custom delimiter in CSV files by registering. Again, you have to use the same method, CSV dot register underscore dialect method. Here you see the same program. So inside the CSV dot register underscore dialect method, my dialect, after that delimiter equal to that vertical line. So delimiter equal to that vertical line, then you see the output. So your values will be separated by the pipeline. Okay, so your page number 259, see the note, your dialect parameter skip initial space. When it is true, white space immediately following the delimiter is ignored. So the default is false. So here you see the output. The output will be separated. Now each and every values will be separated by the pipeline. The next one is CSV file with the line terminator. CSV file with the line terminator. So a line terminator is a string used to terminate lines produced by the writer. So the default values is backslash r or backslash n. We can write a CSV file with a line terminator in Python by registering same method, CSV dot register underscore dialect. So here you see data fruit quantity, that is dictionary keys. Then apple, banana, mango, 5, 7, 8 are called the dictionary values. Then the second third line, you have to register your dialect method. So CSV dot register underscore dialect, then my dialect, then delimiter equal to pipeline, then line terminator equal to backslash n. Backslash n means it will give the new line. Okay, here in the list you have, in a single line you have data equal to fruit quantity, apple 5, banana 7, mango and 8 in a single line. If you are specifying your line terminator, then it will, the apple 5, then banana 7, then mango 8 will be in the new line. So apple 5, after that in new line only banana and 7 will be displayed, then after that the mango and 8 will be displayed in the new line, but that will be separated, that values will be separated by the pipeline. Okay, the next one, CSV files with the code characters. So code characters means, so you have to specify your code character. Then again you have to register your dialect method, the same method, CSV dot register underscore dialect method. In the program, you see page number 260, first program you see CSV inside the dialect method, my dialect, delimiter equal to pipeline, then code character is a double quotes, so that should be enclosed with the quotes. Okay, then what will be your output? You see serial number, then your items serial number will be enclosed with the double quotes. Then the pen, book and pencil will be enclosed with the double quotes. Then the next method. So for each and every method you have to register your CSV dot register dialect method. So next one, writing CSV file into a dictionary. How do you write a CSV file into a dictionary? So using dictionary writer, using dictionary writer module or method, you can write a CSV file into a dictionary. So it creates an object which maps data into a dictionary. The keys are given by the field names as a parameter. The following program helps to write the dictionary into the file. So here you see the data mountain. Mountain is a key. Then Everest is the value. So mountain is Everest. Then height is 8848. Like that on a Moody, then Kanchenjunga. Okay. So here you have your data, sir. You have three datas. Then you have to use the, how do you write this CSV file into a dictionary? You have to use the dictionary writer method. So W equal to CSV dot dictionary writer, CF comma field names equal to fields. So the write rows method, here you see write header. Write header used to write the heading. So mountain and height. Then the write rows method used to write the data into your file. So write rows data, it will be write the data. Then here you see the output, mountain and head are the headers, then Everest, then Honeymoody, then Kanchenjunga are your datas. Okay, then the next one is writing dictionary into a CSV file with custom dialects. So custom dialects means you have to give the quoting. Okay, so quote all, here you see CSV dot register page number 261. The program, the second line you see CSV dot register dialect, my dialect, then delimiter is a pipeline, then quoting equal to CSV dot quote all, then it will give the double quotes to all your datas. In the above program, a custom dialect called my dialect with the pipeline as a delimiter used the field names and headings of each column to write a CSV file. Finally, the dictionary writer method, the dictionary writer to write a dictionary into the new file. So to write the dictionary into the new file. So the next topic is getting data at runtime and writing it in a CSV file. So how do you getting data at runtime? You can even accept the data through keyboard and write it into a CSV file. So that is runtime. During runtime you can give the data, input data into your using the keyboard. So for example, the following program accepts data from the user through keyboard and stores it in the file called dynamic file. So here you see the program. Okay, the next one, points to remember. So in points to remember, so in this program, page number 262, in this program you can give your data during the runtime. So the second and fourth and sixth data can be given during the runtime. Okay, then points to remember, the CSV file is a human readable text file where each line has a number of fields separated by commas or some other delimiters. So CSV file means it's a comma separated values. It is a human readable text file. The Excel files are the binary files, so it is a machine readable file. The CSV file is the human readable file. Then Excel is the binary files, whereas CSV format is a plain text format. The two ways to read a CSV files are, you have to use either csv.reader function or using dictionary reader class. So the default mode of CSV file in reading and writing is a text mode. So binary mode can be used when dealing with the non-text files like images or exe files. So Python has a garbage collector to clean up unreferenced objects. Close method will free up the resources that were tied with the file. So the close method, which is used to free up the resources. By default, CSV file should open automatically in Excel. So by default, CSV files should automatically open the Excel. So the CSV library contains objects and other code to read, write, and process data from CSV files. So the CSV library contains, library means it's a collections of functions. Okay. So that CSV library function contains read, write, and process data from CSV files. Then the skip initial space is used to removing the white space after the delimiters which we are given. Then to sort by more than one column operator, the item getter can be used. Underline, deadline. Item getter is used to sort more than one column. Then dictionary reader class of CSV model creates an object which maps data to dictionary. Then CSV file having custom delimiter is read with the help of csv.register_dialog. So underline that line. The CSV files having custom delimiter is, the files which are having custom delimiter can be read by the help of csv.register_dialog method. So to sort by more than one column, item getter with multiple indices is used. csv.reader and the writer work with list and tuple. Dictionary, csv.dictionary reader and the csv.dictionary writer work with the dictionary. So csv.dictionary reader and csv.dictionary writer take additional argument field names that are used as dictionary keys. So in dictionary reader and dictionary writer, we have used the additional argument that name is dictionary keys. So dictionary key means item name is the dictionary key, means keyboard is the dictionary value. So the function dictionary is used to print the data in dictionary format without order. So the csv.writer method returns a writer object which converts the user's data into delimiter strings. Then the writer row method writes one row, then writer rows method is used to write all the data at once. Adding a new row at the end of the file is called appending a row. Appending means you have to add the new row at the end of your file. So the 13th chapter is over. Then your homework will be page number 266, part 2 and part 3. How to complete your classwork and submit it. It's G15 children. Thank you.